and the suggestions of all the dysfunction, vast exaggeration, Madam Speaker, bordering on untruth. Not a reflection of any kind of reality, Madam Speaker. Loyalty has been described as if it's something that's bad. But loyalty is something that enables us to work together. It enables us to deliver on behalf of the people of our country. And Madam Speaker, we are at a stage now where we should be finalizing the budget and coming down here in a few weeks to deliver it. But yet we're here arguing about wanting to disrupt the government, change the government. Madam Speaker, the representation that was made by the Honourable Leader of the Opposition in his dedication, in his comments on the motion, was that there are a significant number of ministers who don't have agreement on the budget. Madam Speaker, that is not correct. I'm not saying that we don't have one or two issues that are being resolved, Madam Speaker, seeking to resolve them, but that doesn't mean that we can't get it done. The description is one of a government that can't move forward. Well, we do have options. If it turns out that we do not have an option, Madam Speaker, then we will have to deal with it at that time. But we know, we understand the reality that on December 31st of this year, the legal authorization to spend money in this country expires and we have to have a budget in place. We all fully understand that, Madam Speaker. And that is something that will get done. But it will not get done if we spend time down here fighting over who is going to be the leader and who is going to be the government. It is the people who are depending on that. It's the civil servants who have to get paid. It's the people who are going to benefit from all the initiatives that are reflected in the budget that will be harmed by us not being able to get down to business and get that done, get the budget here.